Good evening, everyone. Welcome to Grade Up and welcome to another session of the Rankers series. Today, we are going to begin a very interesting discussion on the complete analysis of the GS mains, which was completed in 2020, recently, just a few days back. And we have with us Dr. Rajesh Mohan, who has graduated from the Government Medical College, Chandigarh, and he's also an ex-AMO officer. He has cleared the UPSC CMS examination, and he is an ex-AMO officer at the Indian Ordnance Factory Health Services. So hello, Dr. Rajesh. Welcome to Grade Up.
Hello. Thank you so much for having me.
Yeah, it's really a pleasure to be talking to you. And we'll have a proper discussion. We'll start off from the essay and we'll have the complete GS 1, 2, 3, 4. A concise discussion. You can give us a bird's eye view of what you felt through the exam so that our students, it can be helpful for them for the coming year 2021. And for also people who have given the exam in 2020, you can fairly gauge yourself, and we'll end the class with a sort of cutoff discussion. Okay, we'll have a brief cutoff sort of analysis. Dr. Rajesh can help us there.
Yeah.
Okay, so Dr. Rajesh, how did you feel this means on the whole? Like, if you were to sum up the mains experience in around 2 to 3 lines, 3 to 4 lines, what would you say?
So first thing I would say is that the mains examination, the topmost priority should be the time management, because most of the people who has cleared the prelims and they are going to mains, the kind of knowledge base would be approximately of the similar level. However, how you are able to present all your views within the limited 3-hour period, it would require a significant amount of training, especially you should be should also have written papers within 3 hours limit beforehand. It should not be first time kind of thing. So you should join some test series as well. Along with that, one thing is you should focus on time management so that you are able to complete the paper on time. But there are so many people, some friends of mine, who are not able to complete the paper on time. So that is a skill one should have with him during this examination.
Compared to last year, what did you feel? Like, what was your biggest takeaway which you felt from last year?
Compared to the last year, I felt the paper two was little difficult compared to the last one. It was difficult to analyze certain questions to find out what is the demand of the question. At the same time, paper four was little lengthy on account of case studies that were given. So lot amount of time was consumed in reading those case studies and then writing on them within the time. With regard to the paper 3 and paper 1, paper 3 I feel was easier compared to the previous trends, because every year, if you see past year papers, there is always one question in paper 3 which most of the people don't know. For example, last year there was this question on Cyberdome, so people didn't know that. So that is the case. Plus 1 year back it was Bose-Einstein condensate question. So that statistics, it was so specific that only people with the high knowledge in that particular field could only attempt, others could not. But this year I feel that paper 3 was comparatively easier because most of the people knew what the questions were. With regard to the paper 1, I feel it was on the expected lines only, and most of the questions were repeats, as we are going to see as we discuss about these papers in detail.
We'll do that.
Need repeats in it.
We'll have a proper discussion of all the ones. And for people who are just joining in, Dr. Rajesh Mohan, he has given interview last year. He has cleared mains last year, and he couldn't make it to the final list. So hopefully he'll make it this year. And he's telling from his experience because he has cleared mains last year, so he can give a broad eye view of the mains this year. So let's begin the discussion of essay. Okay, initially, let's see the essay paper, and you can let us know what did you feel about the essay paper. Yes, I hope the essay paper is visible to you.
So With regard to the essay paper, there are we have to select two topics from Section A and Section B. So the first thing one should keep in mind in essay paper, and that is the basic thing, how to go about selecting the topics. So the number of topics with the philosophical bent of mind keeps on increasing each year. Like last year also, the number increased. This year also, the number of philosophical topics increased. So you cannot avoid philosophical topics. So,
yes, very true.
So in we have to select a philosophical topic, and second, you have to identify a topic in which you can write, you have enough content for it. So either it can be science and technology related topic or some society related topic, because society we read in general studies a lot sometime. But this this year what I felt was some this science and technology topic, which used to be very broad at one point of time, it was very specific. For example, it was a combination. If we see in the Section B, the last topic that was given, it was technology in the is a silent determinant of international relations. So it was a combination of two areas, technology and IR. So so it is going, we can say overlapping of the fields is happening in this particular aspect. Plus there is this Section A. So most of the topics were philosophical topics. If you see, if you can just scroll it down. So all the topics had some relation to the philosophy.
Yeah, through the first Section A especially, there are philosophy. So we can see some sort of division, if I can say so, of the philosophical and the ones which are overlapping with our GS.
Yeah.
Right. This is your culture, which is sociology part about social justice, then technology and IR, where they've overlapped, as you rightly said. So that sort of thing is there. So I would take the biggest takeaway is you cannot skip or you cannot, you know, overlook the philosophy area, right?
There is one more thing I would like to add. So first, selecting a topic is the first step. Afterwards, the second aspect is time management in an essay. Sometimes what happens is that we are not able to finish the first essay within the half time, like 1.5 hours, we are not able to complete it. So in that particular case, the second essay becomes very weak.
Yes.
So we have to properly divide it. And rather than 1 hour, 13 minutes, I will suggest we should try to finish it in 1 hour, 20 minutes. So that, because initially you are in with a fresh mind, because and you will be able to do the analysis in a very good way. But later on, as you have written one complete essay, it would be difficult for your brain to process the new ideas. So you try to finish it in 1 hour, 20 minutes, so that for the second one, you are having appropriate time and you do justice to the second essay topic.
Yes, very true. And for people who are asking in the comments, when there is a screen share happening, when, I mean, the PDF is being shown, the speaker would be a bit small in size. Okay, it's not an issue with Zoom. So whenever I'm sharing screen, you can see, but you can see in the inset. Okay, Sanika, Ritu, Anmol, and all others, have you any other problem rather than the speaker size? Kindly let me know. Fine, so that is about our essay paper. And similarly, Dr. Ayush, let's begin the GS1.
Yeah, so if you can please put the GS1 on the screen.
Yeah,
so
I just could, but before that, you can just start off speaking. I mean, how did you feel GS1? Was it a shocking paper, or was it on expected lines?
So paper one was on expected lines, and as I have said earlier also, most of the questions were repeat, especially in the geography section. So many questions, if you have done past year papers, you would be feeling more comfortable writing because you have seen those questions before. So you will be able to having a psychological relief. Yes, I know this kind of question. So with regard to the question, the paper, we can divide it into basically five parts. So one is art and culture, one is modern India, then post-independence and world history. Then we have society and the geography section. So yes. This time, the post-independence and world history, there was no question at all. So this means these are low input output subjects. So we can prioritize our preparation in a way so that these can be put on the backside, and we just have enough content in order to handle the question if it comes in the paper. So core, it remains art and culture, post-independence, society, and geography. With regard to intra-paper one division, geography had the maximum percentage of questions, followed by society. So if we go difficulty-wise, art and culture questions were a little tricky compared to other subjects. So I think art and culture questions, some questions were very specific. For example, Pala, if you can just show it. So
the first question, second question, right, which is visible.
The role of Pala dynasty in the spread of Buddhism. So in these kind of questions, you have limited amount of knowledge. So, and again, with regard to other questions, like we had one more next question on only, I feel. No, okay, next one is Lord Curzon. So we had... Persian literature question. So even though literature is directly mentioned in the syllabus clearly, art and literature forms, but we generally tend to neglect these areas. So for these things, we should make up a strategy so that we can prepare it well. But in the end, when the exam is going on, we should be able to handle these questions. So what I suggest is that there are two kinds of questions. One are general, like in society. One are specific questions, like in art and culture. So when you know that I do not exactly know all the content about that particular question, so you should be clear in your mind that if I use English and fill the pages, so it won't be fetching me marks. Yeah. So you should be aware about that particular aspect and ensure that you do not waste more time on that particular question. For example, if in Persian literature, if you know a little bit, you write it, but you try to finish in 5-6 minutes so that you get some time to attempt those society questions, which are very general. And those require a little more thinking, more examples, more points. So you can make a better time management in by using these kind of questions, which are very difficult, very tricky. You know that you do not know much, but whatever you know, you try to finish within 5-6 minutes so that you have enough time for the other questions.
Yes. Any continuity did you feel like, were they from last year or, you know, or a continuing thread of the general topics which were asked this year?
So what I feel is that with regard to art and culture, I felt like there is this new NCERT themes. So medieval one. So it has one separate chapter on Persian literature. So we can say one question can be picked from there. But this is a very tricky area, because in that particular case, there would be other books also which would be having one. So you cannot read all of them. So you have you should go with your standard, whatever standard books you are reading, and you should use you should ensure that whatever is given in them, that is properly reproduced in these kind of questions.
Yeah. And in geography, did you feel any topics are repeated, or any topics or any, you know, common themes are important which you felt from this year?
Okay, geography question had 8 questions. So most of them were either repeats or on expected lines. And we could write a lot on those topics. For example, if you go by the repeats, there was one question on circumpacific ring geomorphology. So this is a very static question. It was repeated last year, some years back also. So for that, you can make maps. You should know how to draw a world political map, simple India map. And with even with the knowledge of prelims, you can go with that particular aspect. So for geography, past year papers are key to solve future papers. At the same time, one area of focus which is increasing year after year is with regard to resources, especially water resources. So traditional resources are also there. For example, forest resources, they asked. So that was current linkage was there because a forest survey report also came at, last year, 2019. So, at, but water resources, we had 2-3 questions like interlinking of water, interlinking of rivers, how they can solve the water crisis related problems. Then there was a question on how the glacial melting will impact the water resources. So, for that, we need to put extra effort with regard to water resources. And there is a reason why they are asking, because we are right now in a water stress condition. So that is a real challenge for our country. So we have to focus on water resources and prepare this topic very nicely.
Yes. Anmol, aapka question kya hai? Theek se aap mujhe bataiye, what is the problem? As I've told, when the screen is being shared, the speaker's video is minimized. Okay, if you have some general preparation doubts, we'll take it up towards the end of this class. Okay, let's wrap up this discussion of the whole GS in roughly 45 minutes. Okay, so kindly, any doubts which you have, Dr. Rajesh will be taking it up towards the end of the class. So kindly wait.
Okay, so with regard to paper one last area is the society one. So in society, most of the questions are from directly syllabus line, like regionalism question was there. One, caste, relevance of caste, that is a recurring theme. So every alternate year, they will ask whether caste has lost its relevance or not. So that is an important topic. One, globalization related topic is always there. So this time they attached it with the diversity of India. So sometimes they will ask what is the impact of globalization on women, on various sections, on our culture. So in these the 2 points I would like to communicate to all of them is that, first of all, try to have an introduction based the definition based introduction, because these terms like regionalism, if you are able to define regionalism in introduction, that is the best introduction. Plus, at the same time, you increase the number of points you give, like arguments in support, arguments against. You should have 7 to 8 on both the side, along with examples. So that would require considerable amount of time. Like, you have to do justice with these questions, and they come in the end. So what happens is that during the last 15-30 minutes, you are not able to give adequate amount of time to these questions. So you have to ensure that you give adequate amount of time to these questions. These questions are very easy. So most of the people know what is the impact of globalization. We know what is regionalism. We are very much aware about the examples of regionalism. So we should give adequate amount of time to these questions so that whatever we know are able to produce in the exam sheet.
Yes, very true. So that's for paper one. Let's see for paper two. And Shraddha has asked one relevant doubt here. So please say which format is important for mains answer writing, especially in paper one. Do you think a point-wise analysis is good, or do you think it should be written in paragraph for paper one especially? Because it's a more of a descriptive subject, all of them in paper one.
Yeah. So what I feel is we can divide it into two parts. One is 10 marks question, one is 15 marks question. If you with regard to 10 marks questions, there are 2 pages only. So if we go with the discussion, the paragraph form, it won't be suitable for them. For 10 marks, we should go directly with a point-wise format. Because we have limited space, we cannot write, we can miss the points if we go for a paragraph-wise writing of the answers of 10 marks question. But 15 marks, we can definitely go for a para-wise answering of the question. But in that particular aspect, we have to ensure the one point I can add to it. In 15 marks question, especially in paper one, they will give one side of the question. So there is always an opposite side to it. So this way you can add you can convert it into 2 questions so that you are able to fill the page in a proper way. So paragraph, if you can write, in paper 15 marks questions,
15 markers paragraph in this, yeah, that's correct. And for paper for the first part, we can also draw the flow charts, you know.
Yeah,
in a clear way you can communicate.
With regard to geography question, you should ensure that you make a map some diagram, because without that you may get little lesser marks compared to other people, because everyone is making maps and diagrams. So geography, any geography question came, you should know ki I have to make a diagram into it, and that is a must for it.
Fine, so let's go forward with paper two then.
So paper two this time was tougher. So if we divide it into parts, we can say one is the political political topics. Then second is the governance and social justice related. And the third is international relations. The first part, polity and governance, this is becoming trickier year after year. So the questions were difficult side. And I have discussed with my friends, and most of them are saying these questions were very difficult. For example, first question itself, it was, first of all, not a direct area which we read most of the times, corrupt practices. So for that, we have those people who are giving next year. So they should ensure that you go beyond Lakshmikant. Lakshmikant is good for prelims, but we have to do more analysis of whatever topics that are given. However, having said that, there were certain recurring themes that were evident in the polity-related paper. First theme was that federalism. Federalism is such an important concept that every year some question is there. So you should be prepared with the topics like federalism. I think there were like question third was there, if we can see that. With regard to federalism, how it is. And the second aspect with regard to the polity paper is it's very difficult to understand sometimes these statements, because they give very long statements. And some people get confused in there. So you try to simplify those statements. You give adequate time to read the question. For example, if you can just read the judicial system, judicial legislation 15th question, 12th question of the paper. So it is a long question. So sometimes you may be confused, but it is all about what are the arguments in favor of PIL and what are arguments against the PIL. So you have to deconstruct the question in especially in polity part, so that and make it a little easier, and don't go with the words because they use very difficult kind of words. And try to use your static knowledge that you have with regard to prelims, maximum you can utilize. And if you can make some tables and comparisons, so that would be very helpful in polity. Because in polity, if you directly write, if, for example, this comparison related question, judicial system of India and UK. So we have to compare them. What are the differences? What are the similarities? If you just make a table and make the comparison, so that will be more presentable and more easier for the examiner to check it. So so try to use table comparison tables in difference related questions. So this was about the polity part. So it was very on a difficult side of the spectrum, the polity paper, because questions were like representation of People's Act. The syllabus, the name is mentioned, but the traditional Lakshmikant book, it doesn't cover it properly, because the mechanism of how corrupt practices are to be identified. So in that, if you first of all, you try to increase the depth of your understanding about polity subjects. At the same time, if, for example, you have done and it's new to you, you try to make some differences. For example, it is about disqualification of the MLAs and MPs. So you can say what are the constitutional, what are the legislative. So this way, some more structuring would be available with whatever knowledge you are having. So you can go with that. So this was the polity paper.
The governance part especially, I felt they were very sort of dynamic and rapid questions.
Governance, they first of all, one aspect is that they associate with the current affairs. Even this civil services related question and how it is in the economy, in the context of rising role, the capacity of civil services in economy. So this was inspired from Mission Karmyogi that was in the news. So current affairs aspect is very much relevant in governance. At the same time, for example, the fourth industrial revolution and its linkage with e-governance. So these topics one advantage is that they are easier to attempt because the sources are, you can easily read them. The complexity is not there. It's easy to understand these questions, but you have to link with the current affairs. And they are mostly inspired from the current affairs. So a better understanding of the current affairs will, a better reading of the current affairs would be, would go a long way in helping answer these questions.
Okay, and our IR, the most important IR?
Yeah, so international relations. So there were four questions. So it was a mixed paper. Some were very easy on expected lines. For example, WHO. I think most of the people would have prepared for WHO. So, and then there was this question on Indian diaspora. It is a direct topic that is given. So you should know, you should prepare it in a way so that you can write on this. But there were some complex topics are the other two questions. For example, Quad. So most of the times what we understand of Quad is a military alliance. So it went one step further and asked what are the trade, it is, how it is turning into a trade bloc. So better reading of the newspaper can help. You have to use quotes from various sources. For example, what Minister of our External Affairs, S. Jaishankar, is saying, what Shiv Shankar Menon, what are his opinions. And plus, if you can make a diagram in IR-related questions, then, for example, Indo-Pacific, you can just show what is Indo-Pacific through a world diagram. So that makes an impression on the examiner. So international relations was a mixed topic. Plus, one advantage with the international relations is that if you prepare it well, you can score really good marks in it.
Yes, and they're completely from current affairs. I mean, yeah. People keep asking that, you know, what is the standard book list for IR? So this is testimony to the fact that there is no book list for IR. It is completely from your current affairs and understanding, which I...
No, you are spot on this, because most of the questions are current of, all the questions are current affair. You need not have background understanding like what is the history of India, Iran, India, US. So you just go with whatever current topics are there.
Okay, that's it. And I felt there were several COVID related issues in the polity also. They have Disaster Management Act.
Yeah, and one more thing I will like to add is that they are going for current affairs, which is 2 years old. So it's not only 1 year only. So for example, RTI amendment. So that was in 2019 starting. So the people who are just preparing, so they may not find RTI amendment in current affair booklets. So current affair, you have to prepare for at least 2 years. So that is a minimum.
So one good lesson from this is your current affairs plan for 2021 needs to be at least from Jan 2020.
Yeah.
Okay. So let's go forward with the paper three then.
So paper three this time was a little easier compared to last one. So we can divide it into four parts again. First is the traditional economy related topics, then agriculture related topics, then we can have security related topics, and in the last, the environment, science and technology, disaster management, these topics. Out of these four topics, I will say maximum input output ratio is in agriculture and security, because if you just add because most of the questions were on expected lines, the marketing of agriculture produce was so much in news because of the farm acts that were passed for and food processing was is always there in the news. So it was on expected lines. You just go a little deeper and have understanding, so you can attempt it. You can increase the quality of your answer by making some charts like how the value chain goes in agriculture. So all the topics of agriculture are very important. And if you just read the topic and make a one page a note out of each the topic, you would be able to answer these questions. With regard to security also, security, the weightage is very high. Plus, it is mostly you can predict security. For example, 1 year if there is a border management related question. The next year there will be a left wing extremism. For example, last year there was no question on left wing extremism. So this year the question on that particular aspect came. So insecurity, this time what they did was with regard to left wing extremism, they gave 4 pages to answer this. So you have to be aware about these tricks also. So you attempt it in a better way, and you do not go with the number of pages as such. You go with the content you can have. Okay. So that is there. With regard to the economy, I will say they were easy questions, mostly from traditional areas, basic concepts. So again, I can say that UPSC is focusing on the core concepts, what is potential GDP, what is investment. So it is going towards the core concepts. And one more new trend that I can say has emerged is the number of schemes that are being asked directly is increasing. So there were two schemes. One was Jal Shakti Abhiyan and one was National Clean Air Program. So they were directly asked, whole question was given on it. But these are the topics which we generally read during prelim examination, like schemes. So change in your strategy, what you can do is that for whatever you have read in prelims for all the schemes, at least for the flagship schemes, you revise the flagship schemes before you go for the mains.
Yes. And also, I think science and technology, but anything on science and technology which you felt?
So this time science and technology was easier because it was a general kind of questions, not so specific as it used to be the case before. Before, some very vague concept used to come, one question. So it was very difficult to answer. Now, present one, it is like, what is the role of science and technology in, say, farming? So how it has changed it? What is nanotechnology? How is it helping? So life cycle kind of approach, for example, during the childhood, during adulthood, during elderly, how the science and technology is contributing to the well-being of the society. So I will say this is easy, but the issue with this kind of question is that sometimes we are not able to make a structure out of it. So structuring of the question is important. We should not write purposeless statements. Rather, in a very structured way, we try to give examples and make a flow, try to use life cycle approach. Or you can go for a sectoral approach. So any aspect is given, for example, farming. So you can say inputs, how it has improved the inputs, how the output has been increased. So that gives a structure to these kind of questions.
Yes, Anmol is asking a good question. He's asking, how do you begin an answer? I mean, let us take one question, for example. Let us consider one question, Rajesh, which you can choose one question and you can tell me, how do you introduce and how do you get it to the meat of it and how do you conclude? Especially for, let's take economy question. For example, this was a very sort of theoretical question, the investment and concession agreement, public entity, private entity. If you've written it well, or any question which you've written well, you can kindly let us know.
So we can go with this question. So now this is a 15 marks question. So you have to divide it into best part is that they have already divided it. You have to explain what is the meaning of an investment in terms of capital formation. Then you have to go for the concessionaire agreement. What are the considerations we have to go for? So introduction, you try to define. So what I say is that if you can define in this particular question, that definition is directly asked. So we can give a figure. For example, gross fixed capital formation in the countries, this much percentage. So, but if it is not about defining, you try to define that particular concept. So if now in that aspect, now in you can in the second after introducing with the fact, you can start with the definition of the investment. Then you can say of those sources of investment, like domestic investment, then foreign investment, and how private sector can invest, how public sector can invest. You in economy question, you try to make cycles, because that shows a moving thing. So in this particular, you can relate how this savings are converted into investment and how investment results in capital formation. So this kind of a cycle, like vicious, a virtuous cycle or vicious cycle, this adds value to the economy question. Or you can compare. So now the second aspect, you for example, what is the what are the factors you have to consider into public and private. So while writing the answer, you just see what are the interests of public sector, what are the interests of private sector. So then it would be easier to answer those questions. So for example, how the risk would be shared. So risk, definitely public sector can take more risk, because private sector, if it takes more risk, so it won't be able to come. So in, while designing that particular agreement, risk sharing should be proportionate, where public sector should play a more role. With regard to rewards should also be how they should be distributed between public and private sector. So all these things, after completing that, then you can conclude either with SDGs, or you can conclude from Niti Aayog report at India at 75, or you can use some Atmanirbhar related ideas or some targets, for example, for achieving a dream of $5 trillion economy. So we need to involve private sector as a participant into the investment process. So this way we can go with answering the question. My suggestion, that you have certain 2-3 things in first of all, if you have direct conclusion with regard to conclusion, so try to use it some specific there. If it is not there, you try to use 2-3 backstops. For example, SDGs you can use. SDGs you can use in paper 1 also, paper 2 also, and paper 3 also. Then there are these paper 2 especially, you can use constitutional articles, these commissions like Panchi Commission, Sarkari Commission, you can use. Second ARC, you can use liberally in most of the papers that are there. With regard to economy, you try to use Niti Aayog's India at 75. So that is available. So
I think we'll have another session of answer writing. There, okay. You know, in depth, we can do that.
Okay.
So let's have the last paper discussion, the GS4. What people are waiting for. You can give us some sort of summary of what you felt and a sort of lesson what you have learned.
Okay. So in the paper four, so ethics paper, this time it was lengthier. So it is always a very lengthy paper. So you have to write so many words within 3 years. Second aspect was it was little vague. So the last topic that is there, probity in governance. So that used to carry a significant amount of weightage. There used to be some e-governance related question, something related to code of conduct, something related to say Sevatam model, something related to citizen charter, something. So there was no such question. So all questions were, you have to analyze them. So analytical skills were required at this time. So at the same time, some intermixing with paper one was also given in the first part. For example, teachings of Lord Buddha. So if you can use the paper one knowledge and connect it with the ethics, second, contributions of Savitri Bai Phule. So there was, in a way, it used more analysis, plus it was a little vague, plus it was lengthier also. Plus there was some question which were quote like. So one is the sixth question which is having quotes, so you can analyze them. But other questions were also having some how examine this statement. So this way is there. Plus at the same time, some current affair related topics were also included in the aspect, like new education policy, how it can help improve the capability of a person and a nation, society. How can it transform it? So, this way it became a difficult in the sense that it, the easier questions were not there. Those on the expected lines, they were not there. Second aspect was in the case studies. So if we just see the length of the case studies, we will see what is the problem. So so you have to read it the case study completely. So a lot amount of time is consumed in reading this. You are identifying the stakeholders. So you have to ensure that all the stakeholders' interest is taken into consideration. So in a way, if a person goes for attempting case studies in the second part, so then it becomes tricky for this. So I will suggest try to attempt case studies in the first part and first part of the paper into the second half of the time period. So case studies, time management is important, plus space management is also important, because this time they randomly gave, for one case study, they gave 4 pages, for other one, they gave 3 pages. So this way you have to ensure that you be able to do justice to all the case studies in the given space that is allotted to you. Plus, these case studies were little difficult on side, because last year there were no case studies as such, because they were asking the static portion through case studies like civil services reform. So this time proper case studies were coming. Plus, you have to read the case studies very properly. So for case studies, we can go with an introduction of the polity related articles we can use, associate, and always try to mention stakeholders, because this not only helps in better structuring, plus at the same time, if you suggest a course of action, so you can suggest more course of action by just looking at stakeholders, that this interest of this stakeholder is done by my this step, interest of stakeholder two is taken care by the second one. So, and conclude with some way forward, like what we should go for in the broad scheme of things related to what topic it was, the case study. So this way, finally, I would say that paper 4 was a difficult one. On the similar pattern, like paper 2 was difficult, paper 4 was also difficult, because you have to manage the time, plus you have to analyze those questions. And there were very few places where you could use examples from the civil services, whatever list we make, na, that civil servants, what they have. The only one question was there where we could use examples from civil servant side. So most of the examples we had to use from our GS related. So there was so much interlinkage in paper 4, especially in paper 1 also, plus even examples also, you would need more than civil servant examination, some other general examples you had to substantiate with.
That's very true, Rajesh. Thank you so much for enlightening us. And towards the end, I just wanted to understand, you know, what is your take on the cutoff, like comparing last year, because you've qualified the mains last year, you've given interview last year. I just wanted to know, because we've analyzed obviously, and you've been saying that more or less it's on the same pattern, but paper 3 was easier, paper 1 was tougher, ethics was lengthier. So taking into consideration all these factors, where do you think the cutoff would stand? This is the cutoff for last year.
So,
you can just give an idea about it.
So what I feel is that compared to last year they went for a little stricter marking only. So I feel this year also they will try to reduce the contribution of the optional subject. Like 300 was the top score in most of the subjects. So more focus would be on general studies. So in a way, I will say, because one thing is there, like last year, there can be chances that optional subjects, they will be on the average side. But in general studies, there are high chances that, especially in paper 3, the marking, you can get more marks. So I will say 10-15 marks extra, the cutoff will go higher up, because in paper 3, you can get more marks easily. So yes, that would add to it. So, and plus it's very difficult to constrain marks in that those kind of topics, which are known to everyone. So I will say a cutoff will be like, I think 10 to 12 marks on a higher side this way.
Yes. Actually, I think 2019 cutoff itself was a fall, right? Because 2019 was a tougher side of exam. So this year maybe it can get back to the regular main or expected every year.
Yeah, that is the case.
Okay. So, and for people who wanted the question papers, who've been asking for the question paper, you can just join our group on Telegram at the rate IAS Preparation Strategy. Okay, the Grade Up group, you can find this group, and on this, all the question papers would be uploaded. All right, so don't ask about the question papers. And question papers, of course, you can also find them normally, but on this group, I'll be uploading just after the session. And any other doubts you wanted to ask with Dr. Rajesh, kindly let us know. Anyone? Some doubts they had asked were okay, for the book list, we've had extensive sessions on book list. Harshmeet Singh sir had conducted a book list session. So you can find that. You can go to YouTube and search Grade Up IAS UPSC book list. You'll be getting properly regarding that. And general ka cutoff kitna hoga, Atufa, as sir has told, it'll be roughly on the higher side. So maybe around 760, but it shouldn't cross 770 marks, according to him. Any other doubts? No? All right. So thank you so much, Dr. Rajesh, for joining us today. And we wish you from on the behalf of Grade Up team, we wish you a hearty, I mean, best of luck for your mains. And hopefully you can prepare your, you can begin your interview preparation as soon as possible. And hope you clear the bench this year. Thank you
Thank you
so
so much.
much for joining us.
And I would also
Yeah.
like to extend my wishes to all the viewers of Grade Up and all those who have given the mains. I hope they also clear this examination and those who are preparing for the next year. So I wish them good luck that they make a very structured preparation so that we are so that they are able to make the make it to the list next year. So thank you so much
Yes.
for Okay.
Abba Priya, the option of Rajesh sir was medical science. Okay, his option is medical science. Thank you so much. And see, this is the guidance without which people, you know, the freshers tend to lag on for many years. So these are the lessons which you'll require for mains. So I hope you had a good session. And any other doubts, you can contact us on Telegram. They can be rerouted to Dr. Rajesh. And hopefully, after his selection, he'll come back for a topper's talk with us. And enlighten us, you know, how to prepare for UPSC. Yes, we're waiting. All the we're really wishing you all the best of luck.
Thank you
Okay.
so much.
Thank you so much. Let's meet again for another session tomorrow. Okay. Bye, people.